Milan is a city in northern Italy, capital of Lombardy, and the second most populous city in Italy after Rome. It is the only European city wealthier than its corresponding capital. Milan served as the capital of the Western Roman Empire, the Duchy of Milan and the Kingdom of Lombardy-Venetia. The city proper has a population of about 1.4 million while its metropolitan city has 3.26 million inhabitants. Its continuously built-up urban area, that stretches well beyond the boundaries of the administrative metropolitan city, is the fourth largest in the EU with 5.27 million inhabitants. The population within the wider Milan metropolitan area, also known as Greater Milan, is estimated at 8.2 million, making it by far the largest metropolitan area in Italy and the third largest in the EU. Milan is considered a leading alpha global city, with strengths in the fields of art, commerce, design, education, entertainment, fashion, finance, healthcare, media, services, research and tourism. Its business district hosts Italy's stock exchange, and the headquarters of national and international banks and companies. In terms of GDP, it has the second largest economy among EU cities after Paris, and is the wealthiest among EU non-capital cities. Milan is viewed as part of the Blue Banana and one of the four motors for Europe. The city has been recognized as one of the world's four fashion capitals thanks to several international events and fairs, including Milan Fashion Week and the Milan Furniture Fair, which are currently among the world's biggest in terms of revenue, visitors and growth. It hosted the Universal Exposition in 1906 and 2015. The city hosts numerous cultural institutions, academies and universities, with 11% of the national total of enrolled students. Milan received 10 million visitors in 2018, with the largest numbers of foreign visitors coming from China, United States, France and Germany. The tourists are attracted by Milan's museums and art galleries that include some of the most important collections in the world, including major works by Leonardo da Vinci. The city is served by many luxury hotels and is the fifth most starred in the world by Michelin Guide. Milan is also home to two of Europe's most successful football teams, AC Milan and FC Internazionale, and one of Europe's main basketball teams, Olimpia Milano. Milan will host the 2026 Winter Olympics together with Cortina d'Ampezzo. Toponymy. The etymology of the name Milan remains uncertain. One theory holds that the Latin name Mediolanum comes from the Latin words medio and planus. However, some scholars believe that lanum comes from the Celtic root lan, meaning an enclosure or demarcated territory in which Celtic communities used to build shrines. Hence Mediolanum could signify the central town or sanctuary of a Celtic tribe. Indeed, about 60 Gallo-Roman sites in France bore the name Mediolanum, for example, Saintes and Evreux. In addition, another theory links the name to the boar, so an ancient emblem of the city, fancifully accounted for in Andrea Alciato's emblemata, beneath a woodcut of the first raising of the city walls, where a boar is seen lifted from the excavation, and the etymology of Mediolanum given as half-wool, explained in Latin and in French. According to this theory, the foundation of Milan is credited to two Celtic peoples, the Bituriges and the Aedui, having as their emblems a ram and a boar. Therefore, the city's symbol is a wool-bearing boar, an animal of double form, here with sharp bristles, there with sleek wool. Alciato credits Ambrose for his account. History. Prehistory and Roman times. The Celtic Insubers, the inhabitants of the region of northern Italy called Insubria, appear to have founded a settlement around 600 BC. According to the legend reported by Livy, the Gaulish king Ambicatus sent his nephew Belufsis into northern Italy at the head of a party drawn from various Gaulish tribes. Belufsis allegedly founded the settlement in the times of the Roman monarchy, during the reign of Tarquinius Priscus. Tarquin is traditionally recorded as reigning from 616 to 579 BC, according to ancient Roman historian Titus Livy. During the Roman Republic, the Romans, led by consul Gnaeus Cornelius Scipio Calvus, fought the Insubers and captured the settlement in 222 BC. The chief of the Insubers then submitted to Rome, giving the Romans control of the settlement. They eventually conquered the entirety of the region, calling the new province Cisalpine Gaul, Gaul this side of the Alps, and may have given the site its Latinized name of Mediolanum. In Gaulish asterisk medio meant middle, center, and the name element lanon is the Celtic equivalent of Latin planum, plain, thus asterisk Mediolanum meant in the midst of the plain. In 286, the Roman Emperor Diocletian moved the capital of the Western Roman Empire from Rome to Mediolanum. Diocletian himself chose to reside at Nicomedia in the Eastern Empire, leaving his colleague Maximian at Milan. Maximian built several gigantic monuments: the large circus, the Thermae or Baths of Hercules, a large complex of imperial palaces and other services and buildings of which few visible traces remain. Maximian increased the city area to 375 acres by surrounding it with a new, larger stone wall with many 24-sided towers. The monumental area had twin towers. One included in the convent of San Maurizio Maggiore remains 16.6 meters high. From Mediolanum, the Emperor Constantine issued the Edict of Milan in 313 AD, granting tolerance to all religions within the empire, and thus paving the way for Christianity to become the dominant religion of Roman Europe. Constantine was in Mediolanum to celebrate the wedding of his sister to the Eastern Emperor, Licinius. In 402, the Visigoths besieged the city and the Emperor Honorius moved the imperial residence to Ravenna. In 452, Attila in his turn besieged Mediolanum, but the real break with the city's imperial past came in 539, during the Gothic War, when Uriah laid Mediolanum to waste with great loss of life. The Lombards took Ticinum as their capital in 572, and left early medieval Milan to the governance of its archbishops. Middle Ages. After the siege of the city by the Visigoths in 402, the imperial residence moved to Ravenna. An age of decline began, which worsened when Attila, king of the Huns, sacked and devastated the city in 452 AD. In 539, the Ostrogoths conquered and destroyed Milan during the Gothic War against Byzantine Emperor Justinian I. In the summer of 569, the Lombards conquered Milan, overpowering the small Byzantine garrison left for its defense. Some Roman structures remained in use in Milan under Lombard rule. Milan surrendered to Charlemagne and the Franks in 774. The 11th century saw reaction against the control of the Holy Roman Emperors. City-states emerged in northern Italy, an expression of the new political power of the cities and their will to fight against all feudal powers. Milan was no exception. It did not take long, however, for the Italian city-states to begin fighting each other to try to limit neighboring powers. The Milanese destroyed Lodi and continuously warred with Pavia, Cremona and Como, who in turn asked Frederick I Barbarossa for help. In a sally, they captured Empress Beatrice and forced her to ride a donkey backwards through the city until getting out. These brought the destruction of much of Milan in 1162. A fire destroyed the storehouses containing the entire food supply, and within just a few days Milan was forced to surrender. A period of peace followed and Milan prospered as a center of trade due to its position. During this time the city was considered among the largest European cities. In 1395, Gian Galeazzo Visconti became the first Duke of Milan after receiving the title from Wenceslaus, King of the Romans. In 1447, Filippo Maria Visconti, Duke of Milan, died without a male heir. Following the end of the Visconti line, the Ambrosian Republic was established. It took its name from Saint Ambrose, the popular patron saint of the city. Both the Guelph and the Ghibelline factions worked together to bring about the Ambrosian Republic in Milan. Nonetheless, the Republic collapsed when, in 1450, Milan was conquered by Francesco I of the House of Sforza, which made Milan one of the leading cities of the Italian Renaissance. Early modern. Milan's last independent ruler, Lodovico il Moro, requested the aid of Charles VIII of France against the other Italian states, eventually unleashing the Italian Wars. The king's cousin, Louis of Orléans, took part in the expedition and realized most of Italy was virtually defenseless. This prompted him to come back a few years later in 1500, and claim the Duchy of Milan for himself, his grandmother having been a member of the ruling Visconti family. At that time, Milan was also defended by Swiss mercenaries. After the victory of Louis's successor François I over the Swiss at the Battle of Marignan, the duchy was promised to the French King François I when the Spanish Habsburg Emperor Charles V defeated François I at the Battle of Pavia in 1525, northern Italy, including Milan, passed to Habsburg Spain. In 1556, Charles V abdicated in favor of his son Philip II and his brother Ferdinand I. Charles's Italian possessions, including Milan, passed to Philip II and remained with the Spanish line of Habsburgs, while Ferdinand's Austrian line of Habsburgs ruled the Holy Roman Empire. the Great Plague of Milan in 1629-31, that claimed the lives of an estimated 60,000 people out of a population of 130,000, caused unprecedented devastation in the city and was effectively described by Alessandro Manzoni in his masterpiece, The Betrothed. This episode was seen by many as the symbol of Spanish bad rule and decadence and is considered one of the last outbreaks of the centuries-long pandemic of plague that began with the Black Death. In 1700, the Spanish line of Habsburgs was extinguished with the death of Charles II. After his death, the War of the Spanish Succession began in 1701 with the occupation of all Spanish possessions by French troops backing the claim of the French Philippe of Anjou to the Spanish throne. In 1706, the French were defeated in Ramillies and Turin and were forced to yield northern Italy to the Austrian Habsburgs. In 1713-1714, the treaties of Utrecht and Rastatt formally confirmed Austrian sovereignty over most of Habsburg Spain's Italian possessions, including Lombardy and its capital, Milan. Napoleon invaded Italy in 1796, and Milan was declared capital of the Cisalpine Republic. Later, he declared Milan capital of the Kingdom of Italy and was crowned King of Italy in the cathedral. Once Napoleon's occupation ended, the Congress of Vienna returned Lombardy and Milan to Austrian control in 1815. Late modern and contemporary. On March 18, 1848, Milan efficaciously rebelled against Austrian rule during the so-called 5 days that forced Field Marshal Radetzky to temporarily withdraw from the city. The bordering kingdom of Piedmont-Sardinia sent troops in order to protect the insurgents and organized a plebiscite that ratified by a huge majority the unification of Lombardy with Piedmont-Sardinia. But just a few months later, the Austrians were able to send fresh forces that routed the Piedmontese army at the Battle of Custoza on the 24th of July and to reassert Austrian control over northern Italy. About 10 years later, however, Italian nationalist politicians, officers and intellectuals such as Cavour, Garibaldi and Mazzini were able to gather a huge consensus and to pressure the monarchy to forge an alliance with the new French Empire of Napoleon III in order to defeat Austria and establish a large Italian state in the region. At the Battle of Solferino in 1859, French and Italian troops heavily defeated the Austrians that retreated under the Quadrilateral Line. Following this battle, Milan and the rest of Lombardy were incorporated into Piedmont-Sardinia, which then proceeded to annex all the other Italian statlets and proclaim the birth of the Kingdom of Italy on March 17, 1861. The political unification of Italy enhanced Milan's economic dominance over northern Italy. A dense rail network, whose construction had started under Austrian patronage, was completed in a brief time, making Milan the rail hub of northern Italy and, with the opening of the Gothard and Simplon railway tunnels, the major South European rail hub for goods and passenger transport. Indeed, Milan and Venice were among the main stops of the Orient Express that started operating from 1919. Abundant hydroelectric resources allowed the development of a strong steel and textile sector and, as Milanese banks dominated Italy's financial sphere, the city became the country's leading financial center. Very rapid industrialization in the last two decades of the 1800s led to the birth of a massive worker class as well as bitter social conflicts. In May 1898, Milan was shaken by the Bava Bakari's massacre, a riot related to soaring cost of living. Milan's economic dominance in Italy secured also a leading role for the city on the political scene. It was in Milan that Benito Mussolini built his political and journalistic careers, and his fascist black shirts rallied for the first time in the city's Piazza San Sepolcro. Here the future fascist dictator launched his march on Rome on the 28th of October 1922. During the Second World War, Milan's large industrial and transport facilities suffered extensive damage from Allied bombings that often hit also residential districts. When Italy surrendered in 1943, German forces occupied and plundered most of northern Italy, fueling the birth of a massive resistance guerrilla movement. On April 29, 1945, the American 1st Armored Division was advancing on Milan, but, before it arrived, the Italian resistance seized control of the city and executed Mussolini along with his mistress and several regime officers, that were later hanged and exposed in Piazzale Loreto, where 1 year before some resistance members had been executed. During the post-war economic boom, the reconstruction effort and the so-called Italian economic miracle attracted a large wave of internal migration to Milan. The population grew from 1.3 million in 1951 to 1.7 million in 1967. During this period, Milan was rapidly rebuilt, with the construction of several innovative and modernist skyscrapers, such as the Torre Velasca and the Pirelli Tower, that soon became the symbols of this new era of prosperity. The economic prosperity was, however, overshadowed in the late 1960s and early 1970s during the so-called Years of Lead, when Milan witnessed an unprecedented wave of street violence, labor strikes, and political terrorism. The apex of this period of turmoil occurred on the 12th of December 1969, when a bomb exploded at the National Agrarian Bank in Piazza Fontana, killing 17 people and injuring 88. In the 1980s, with the international success of Milanese houses, Milan became one of the world's fashion capitals. The city saw also a marked rise in international tourism, notably from America and Japan, while the stock exchange increased its market capitalization more than fivefold. This period led the mass media to nickname the metropolis Milano da bere, literally, Milan to be drunk. However, in the 1990s, Milan was badly affected by Tangentopoli, a political scandal in which many politicians and businessmen were tried for corruption. The city was also affected by a severe financial crisis and a steady decline in textiles, automobile and steel production. Berlusconi's Milano 2 and Milano 3 projects were the most important housing projects of the 1980s and 1990s in Milan and brought to the city new economical and social energy. In the early 21st century, Milan underwent a series of sweeping redevelopments over huge former industrial areas. Two new business districts, Porta Nuova and CityLife, were built in the space of a decade, radically changing the skyline of the city. Its exhibition center moved to a much larger site in Rho. The long decline in traditional manufacturing has been overshadowed by a great expansion of publishing, finance, banking, fashion design, information technology, logistics and tourism. The city's decades-long population decline seems to have partially reverted in recent years, as the commune gained about 100,000 new residents since the last census. The successful rebranding of the city as a global capital of innovation has been instrumental in its successful bids for hosting large international events such as 2015 Expo and 2026 Winter Olympics. Geography, topography. Milan is located in the northwestern section of the Po Valley, approximately halfway between the River Po to the south and the foothills of the Alps, with the Great Lakes to the north, the Ticino River to the west and the Adda to the east. The city's land is flat, the highest point being at 122 meters above sea level. The administrative commune covers an area of about 181 square kilometers, with a population, in 2013, of 1,324,169 and a population density of 7,315 inhabitants per square kilometer. The metropolitan city of Milan covers 1,575 square kilometers and in 2015 had a population estimated at 3,196,825, with a resulting density of 2,029 inhabitants per square kilometer. A larger urban area, comprising parts of the provinces of Milan, Monza e Brianza, Como, Lecco and Varese, is 1,891 square kilometers wide and has a population of 5,270,000 with a density of 2,783 inhabitants per square kilometer. The concentric layout of the city center reflects the Navili, an ancient system of navigable and interconnected canals, now mostly covered. The suburbs of the city have expanded mainly to the north, swallowing up many comuni along the roads towards Varese, Como, Lecco and Bergamo. Climate. Milan features a mid-latitude humid subtropical climate, according to the Köppen climate classification. Milan's climate is similar to much of northern Italy's inland plains, with hot, humid summers and cold, foggy winters. The Alps and Apennine Mountains form a natural barrier that protects the city from the major circulations coming from northern Europe and the sea. During winter, daily average temperatures can fall below freezing and accumulations of snow can occur. The historic average of Milan's area is 25 centimeters in the period between 1961 and 1990, with a record of 90 centimeters in January 1985. In the suburbs, the average can reach 36 centimeters. The city receives on average 7 days of snow per year. The city is often shrouded in thick cloud or fog during winter, although the removal of rice paddies from the southern neighborhoods and the urban heat island effect have reduced this occurrence in recent decades. Occasionally, the fern winds cause the temperatures to rise unexpectedly. On the 22nd of January 2012, the daily high reached 16 degrees Celsius, while on the 22nd of February 2012, it reached 21 degrees Celsius. Air pollution levels rise significantly in wintertime when cold air clings to the soil, causing Milan to be one of Europe's most polluted cities. Summers in Milan are hot and humidity levels are high, with peak temperatures reaching temperatures above 35 degrees Celsius. Due to the high humidity, urban heat effect and lack of wind, night times often remain muggy during the summer months. Usually the summer enjoys clearer skies with an average of more than 13 hours of daylight. When precipitations occur though, there is a higher likelihood of them being thunderstorms and hailstorms. Springs and autumns are generally pleasant, with temperatures ranging between 10 and 20 degrees Celsius. These seasons are characterized by higher rainfall, especially in April and May. Relative humidity typically ranges between 45% and 95% throughout the year, rarely dropping below 27%, and reaching as high as 100% wind is generally absent. Over the course of the year, typical wind speeds vary from 0 to 14 km per hour, rarely exceeding 29 km per hour, except during summer thunderstorms when winds can blow strong. In the spring, gale force windstorms may happen, generated either by tramontane blowing from the Alps or by Bora-like winds from the north. Due to its geographic location surrounded by mountains on three sides, Milan is among the least windiest cities in Europe. What?